The European Court of Human Rights decided to make blasphemy against the Prophet Muhammad illegal in Europe.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
Hey guys, Tyler here. If you guys like my channel, be sure to go to my social media accounts on both Facebook and Twitter. Also, if you guys want to support me financially, be sure to go to my Patreon page or my PayPal page in the links in the description down below. Here's a statement from the European Court of Human Rights. Calling Muhammad a pedophile may lead to a conviction of disparaging religious doctrines and is not in breach of Article 10. The court in particular that the domestic court comprehensively address the wider context of the applicant's statement and carefully balance her right to freedom of expression with the rights of others to have their religious feelings protected and to have religious peace preserved in Austria. It's held by considering the impugned statements as going beyond the permissible limits of an objective debate and classifying them as an abuse attack on the Prophet of Islam, which could stir up prejudice and put at risk religious peace, the domestic courts put forth relative and significant reasons. Translation: if you were to criticize Muhammad in European countries, you're basically setting yourself for like some time in jail or a possible fine. How fantastic. What's even more ironic is the fact that the Irish people decided to vote away blasphemy law in their country, and now they're getting a new form of blasphemy law. The media always portray the Irish people as always lucky, but I'm sorry, you guys are not lucky this time around. What's also ironic, besides the fact that Ireland voted out blasphemy law to get new blasphemy law, is the fact that the European Court of Human Rights called themselves the European Court of Human Rights. If the European Court of Human Rights knew a thing or two about human rights, what they would know is that criticism and free speech is basically the most basic of human rights. Is it true that religious criticism is not always flattering? Absolutely. However, just because you don't like the criticism does not mean that the person does not have a right to criticize your faith or any ideas that you hold. Additionally, there are some evidence to show that Muhammad was in fact a literal pedophile. Aisha, Allah be pleased with her, reported that Allah's apostle married her when she was 7 years old, and she was taken to his house as a bride when she was 9 and the dolls were with her, and when he, the Holy Prophet, died, she was 18 years old. This direct quotation comes directly from the Hadith. However, keep in mind that the majority of Muslims are Sunni and the minority are Shias, meaning that the majority of the Muslims in the world do believe in the Hadith while other Muslims do not believe in the Hadith. Let's just say for the sake of argument that the Hadith is not authentic, it is not true, and that Aisha actually married Muhammad when she was much older. Even if that claim was not true, I still believe that people have a right to criticize religion, whether it's in form or not in form, and that nobody should be persecuted by the state just because they have a difference of opinion. It does not matter if you're a Muslim or a Christian or a Buddhist or an atheist like me, I think criticizing a religion or a set of ideas should be standard, and that everybody should agree at the fact that criticism is healthy and actually allow people to self-reflect on their ideas. What do you guys think about this law? Please tell me in the comment section down below. And until next time guys, take care.